Hi, I'm Quan. In this video, I'm going to share with you on how you can do your marking or grading of assignments or examination using Adobe Acrobat Reader. As long as the submission is made in the form of PDF files, you may easily do your marking using the built-in annotation tools, which I'm going to show you shortly. Once the online assignments or tests were completed and submitted by your students to you, either via emails or sharing a file like this, maybe through Google Drive, the next step would be to do the marking and also assessment. So normally what we can do is that one of the ways that maybe you can download the entire folder and place it in your laptop or your computer, then you will have the list of files. You can then easily retrieve all the downloaded files from your folder, such as this. As long as the submission is in the form of PDF, regardless whether it is typewritten like this, or it can be maybe handwritten or scanned copy like this, you can actually do the marking easily using the Acrobat Reader. If you don't have the Adobe Acrobat Reader installed in your computer yet, you can simply download for free at the official website. If you have installed the Adobe Acrobat Reader in your computer, you can just simply open your PDF file by just clicking like this. So like for instance, we have two files over here. So how to do the marking? You will see a list of tools on your right hand side and pick comment. Once you click it, you shall be able to see additional toolbars on top of the screen. So you have things like you can place sticky notes, you can have highlighters, you can do some underlining, you can cross. So there are many options on top of it, and also the pen option, the eraser, even rubber stamp function. So there are a lot of things to explore from this particular toolbars. If you do not have access to touchscreen laptop or drawing tablets or digital pen, don't worry, you can use all the options over here. So by just typing your comment in, so like for instance, maybe you want to give comment to this particular thing, then you can just pick the options, then you can cross it, okay? Or you can just cross it and you can make some comment if you want. So there are plenty of options, okay, that you can use, or you want to add a text box and you just say, oh, this is actually 8 out of 10, something like this, or you can just add text to certain comment, okay? So a lot of functions available, so it's up to you to explore it. But if you have the access to digital pen, I would recommend you to use the drawing options over here. So you can use the drawing tool, so you just click and pick the colors that you want, like for instance maybe red color, then you can start writing. So like for instance, it's like normal marking on the paper, so you just have to just take, then you just say, oh okay, so take, this is wrong, then you can just circle, you can underline, something like this, then you can say, oh, this is actually 8 out of 10. So pretty much it's like writing on a paper. This drawing tool is especially helpful if the submitted work is in the scanned file like this, or handwritten submission. If let's say we were to go back to comment, so just click comment, and again you will see all the tools on top. The limitation of scanned copy or handwritten work is that you can't really use much on the text option, because they can't recognize this as text unless you convert this to OCR. So otherwise, pen option would be very useful. So again, as usual, so you just use the pen that you have, then you just do the marking accordingly. Okay, circle, then you can just scroll down, then you can just say something like this. Okay, then again you can allocate marks over here, then you have exactly like what you write on a piece of paper. Once you have done the marking, you can just easily save the files like this. So you just have to click save, then you save to the folder that you have earlier. So you just save. You can overwrite it, or you save in the different files. So same goes to here. So you just do the normal saving process. So if you replaced it and you go back to the folders that you had earlier, Then you just double click, you'll be seeing the file after the marking. So you can have a record for all the marks that you have, all the works that have been submitted and marked in your folder. And pretty much you are done. I do hope that this video is helpful. Apart from Adobe Acrobat Reader, if you wish to know more about how you can integrate the marking and assessment to your Google Classroom, you can try Kami Extension. To find out more, you can click on this link. Thank you for watching and happy teaching!